So let's do like 7.9. I'm just making something up. And let's do 1. Okay, I got 6.9. So this is working, and we are done with this part. Tiffany Arielle here, and we are back with another video in our Learn to Code series. So today we are starting a series of assignments, or it's really one assignment, but it's a series of videos for this one assignment, which is Console Academy. So today we are doing part 1, which is sandcastles. So it says the sandcastle problems are meant to be fairly straightforward and make sure you're solid on particular concepts like control flow, variables, and functions before moving on to writing larger programs. They're kind of like building sandcastles in a sandbox. They're meant to be fun to do and no one gets hurt. Do these problems first. So part A is write a program in the file subtractNumbers.py that reads two real numbers from the user and prints the first number minus the second number. You can assume the user will always enter valid real numbers as input, which basically they're saying that we don't need to do error checking. It says, yes, we know this problem is really similar to a problem we did in class. Well, I wasn't in class, so I don't know what that was. Sample run of the program is shown below. Okay, so what we're gonna do is I'm just gonna copy this first. And I'm gonna go to my PyCharm. So here we don't need any type of starter code. This is just basic Python built-in library functions. So I've just created a file called subtract_numbers.py. And this is just the same thing I just told you. And so we're gonna start, right? So first, there's a function called print. I don't think we've been using print in previous videos, but for the print function, all you have to do is write print, and then in parentheses, you put whatever string it is that you're trying to print. In this case, I'm trying to print just a string literal, which means I'm not referencing any variables in my string. So I just put the entire thing in quotes. Now, your first instinct may be to do something like this, print enter first number, right? Which you could do this. And actually we will do this, and then I'll show you a better way afterwards. So we have print enter first number, then we need to get the first number. So how do we get the first number? There is a method called input. We don't need this 5.5 because that's like the simulated message. So we need an input, and we need to store the variable. So we're gonna just call it num1 equals input. Now, one thing to remember is that this input function, it's gonna return a string, but we're trying to do addition or subtraction in this case. We cannot really just subtract a string from another string. So we need to convert it into a number. Now, they said that these are real numbers. They did not say that these are integers. So we should assume that it's possible that these numbers could be decimals. So for example, the example was 5.5. So we don't want to do something like this, because if we did something like this, if I were to type in 5.5, this would just give me 5, which is not what I want. What I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna use floating point numbers, which is gonna allow me to have my decimals. So I'm gonna have num1 equals. So what this means is that I'm first getting the input, and then that input is being converted into a float. So you start from the inside and work your way out. So then of course I need to do this again to get the second number. So I'm just gonna do the same thing, but just with num2. But of course I would also need to tell them to enter the second number. And okay, so then I have two numbers, right? So subtraction is easy. All I have to do is just say result equals num1 minus num2. Actually, I really don't even have to do that. And then I want to print the result. Let's say result is, and then I can do concatenation here. So if I do plus in the case of strings, it's just gonna like merge the two strings together. So result is result. So I can do that. What is this? Oh, but see, it's giving me a message because it's saying it expected type string and it got a float. So I need to convert this float into a string using the like string function. So now I'm not seeing any errors. So let's see if this works. So we'll go to run, subtract numbers. Okay, first number, let's do 5.5, 3.1. and it gave me 2.4, and that looks correct. Okay, so now I'm gonna show you the better way. So you notice how it says enter first number and my numbers are on a different line. So this is fine, but what you can do, which actually makes your program look simpler, is you can specify your message here. So I could just copy this all. Oops. I don't know what I just did. So I can copy this and I can put this here. And then I can do the same thing here. And then I don't need this. And I don't need this. Now this just looks a little bit simpler. It makes it more clear that this message goes along with this function. So let's run this again. And you can see that now it's asking me for my number on the same line. So let's do like 7.9. I'm just making something up. And let's do 1. Okay, I got 6.9. So this is working and we are done with this part. Okay, so the second part is to write a program in the file randomnumbers.py that prints 10 random integers. Each random integer should have a value between 0 and 100 inclusive. Your program should use a constant called numRandom, which determines the number of random numbers to print with a value of 10. It should also use constants named minRandom and maxRandom to determine the minimal and maximal values of the random numbers generated. To generate random numbers, you should use the function random.randomInt from Python's random library. Okay, so we are here inside of randomnumbers.py, and it's telling us we should use a constant numRandom, so let's go ahead and define that. Which is supposed to have a value of 10, okay? It says I'm supposed to have constant minRandom, which should have 0, and maxRandom, which has 100, okay? Then it's saying I should print 10 numbers, which is nonrandom. Okay, I already got that. Okay, so how do I generate a random number? First, let's just see. It says I can generate random numbers using random.randomInt. Okay, so we have random.randInt. This is complaining, but you see this little red light bulb is here. So if I click on there, it's saying I can import it. So I'm just gonna click that. And I'm gonna click no. I think I just wanna import random. I don't think I wanna do that. This is complaining about something. Oh, okay. So it's asking me to do values A and B. I think what it is. Let's actually look this up. Python randint. And we click. And what is it saying? Okay, so this is the function, right? So this is what we're looking for. So it says random.randint, and you have to specify a and b. And then it says it returned a random integer n such that a is less than or equal to n, which is less than or equal to b. Okay, so a and b look like they should be our min random and max random. So let's go ahead and put that here. Min random and max random. And let's just see if we get a random number. And then we'll worry about or a seemingly random number. We'll worry about the rest later. So let's run random numbers. Okay, it gave me 10. I mean, it's in the range, seems reasonable. Let's run it again and see if we get 94. Okay, cool. So that seems to be giving us one random number. So it's telling me that I should print numRandom. So we've done for loops before. So all we need to do is use our little for I in range option, and we have our constant numRandom. And I put my colon here, and this is what I'm gonna do. I'm just gonna, numRandom is 10, so this means I'm gonna execute this loop 10 times and I'm gonna print a random integer each time. So now I run this and I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, and we are done. Okay, what is next? Okay, we have part C. So part C is write a program in the file liftoff.py that prints out the calls for a spaceship that is about to launch. Count down the numbers from 10 to 1 and then write liftoff. Your program should include a for loop using range. A sample run of the program is below. Okay, it's literally just 10 to 1 and then liftoff. So Okay, so right now we're going to write this in liftoff.py. So it says you're supposed to use range. So let's assume we have to do the same thing for I in range 10, which I don't really want to do this. Let's just say countdown. Let's utilize a function. So we'll make a countdown equals 10. So we're going to do this and we're going to use this function, countdown. So let's say I need to print the number. And then at the end, I need to print liftoff. I think that should work, right? Let's find out. Run liftoff. Oh, that's not what I wanted. This is giving me 0 to 9. Now this is the thing. Range is always going to start from the smaller number and it's always going to go to the bigger number. So we want to do it backwards. We're counting down. We're not counting up. So there's a way we can do this, and all I have to do is do reversed range countdown. So now if I run this again, I have 9, 8, 7, 6, blah, blah, blah. But that's still not exactly right because we wanted 10 to 1. So all I'm going to do, so I have a couple different options, right? I could modify this range function. So I could make my range go from 1 to countdown, which I'm pretty sure this is actually not going to work. I'll show you why this doesn't work. Because see here, it goes gave from 9 to 1, but I'm still missing 10. So I could do this. I could do one range of 1 to countdown plus 1, in which case that's going to give me 10 to 1. So that's one option. Or the other option is to keep my range the way that it was and just print I plus 1. And that also works. So that is it for liftoff, and I think that is all for sandcastles. So that is it for today. We have just done part 1 of this assignment 2. There's 2 more parts in this assignment, which I'll be doing in future videos. But in the meantime, don't forget to like, subscribe, and share with all your friends. And I'll see you guys next time. Bye.